thousand miles.
Not yet. Starting now. Go.
Parts in this thing. Original parts. Let's talk about that. Because some of those original parts are the brakes. It's mind blowing. 170,000 miles original brakes, and with all the pulling that he does.
Yeah, when you're doing a lot of towing, obviously it's going to tax the braking system because you've got a lot more weight you have to stop. So you would think that this thing would just metal on metal at this point.
I like it though. He does. Like, he uses the truck. Use the truck for pull the trailers, work it, move main stuff.
So we decided to call up the guys at Pacific Performance Engineering because they're problem solvers. Especially when you're talking about Duramaxes from 2001 and up, they really honed in that area.
So we've got a lot of parts laid out here. This isn't even everything that we have, right? Because off to the side, we've got the upgraded transmission pan, the oil pan, all that.
Stop recording me.
Another thing that we're doing today is on the inside of
that
transfer
case. Don't record me. I don't like that.
Which is just another one of these issues that we'll get into all the details on that later. But you talk about a lot of problems being solved. I'm seeing it right here.
Yeah, he's already solved some of those problems. He's went ahead and put on new exhaust manifold system, a high flow system that's going to reduce back pressure, give him a little bit more get up and go. And it looks good here, too.
So he's going to do a lot of driving, right? Obviously, we've covered that. He wants to keep that transmission as smooth as possible. This training wheel will come in handy.
All right, I said we get to work on it. In an effort to give you guys full disclosure, a lot of work got done to get to this point. Obviously, it was getting the truck up in the air and then removing the cross members as well as the drive shafts and all the electrical connections to this transfer case because that is our first order of business.
So inside the transfer case, there's a pump that basically distributes all of the fluid everywhere it needs to go. The way that the pump sits in its housing, it doesn't sit in there perfectly tight. It kind of rolls back and forth just a little bit.
Get them off.
Over time.
Get him! Get him!
Comfortable.
The problem is you can't see that.
Oh.
Because you see it from the outside. So by the time you see it, you got big problems. Right?
Yeah, the deal is, and this is a common case with not only GMCs, but Chevrolets as well. So that's why we're aware of it, and that's why we're trying to address it now rather than have a problem later.
Sure, and we can get in there, and that'll be a lot easier to see, you know, over there on the table. Yeah. We can get in there and see how bad the problem is. If it's not bad, it never will.
Alright, you ready? I think we're clear.
Yeah, you good? What do you need to do? Come your way?
Just, if stuff goes bad, get out of the way. Get back.
Yeah. Alright, perfect. Drop it down.
Watch yourself. Yeah. Come down, buddy.
You got that, dude. Just catch up.
Man, I got everything disconnected.
Alright. Man, we don't have to replace any wire. That's good. With the case out of the truck, we've got a couple of different things that we need to do.